Ready.
I'm Dr. Vivek Gupta in Apollo Hospital, New Delhi, which is one of the private setup, large chain of hospital in South Delhi. I'm Dr. Vivek Gupta with Mr. Basant Gupta, who is also a technician, but very important part of the team. I think he's working for last 15 years. I'm here for last 20 years. This patient is a very interesting case. He had an angiography. He's about 60-year-old male, quite heavy, obese. And he had an angiography done in another government hospital, in the government hospital, where he was found to have triple vessel disease. This patient came to us as a free ward category. In Apollo Hospital, Delhi, we are treating free patients also. And as a part of a protocol, and he came to us and I admitted in this patient, thinking that I will be able to proceed to do angioplasty or bypass surgery. We wanted to do a check angiography because there was some shots which were not very clear. This patient came to, when we did an angiography, we found that RCA was 100% occluded. It was partially collateralized and the lesion in the LAD was in the mid LAD as well as circumflex, mid as well as proximal and distal OM, large OM. We thought we should do angioplasty, but considering that he had the calcified lesions and he also had his stents done in the proximal LAD as well as in the distal part of circumflex earlier. Patient was always already advised bypass surgery by the government hospital, and therefore patient wanted that we can take a chance of surgery. We referred this patient to surgical team, and surgical team thought that considering that the patient may not have direct angina, although I think that patient had severe ischemia, which was part of silent angina, and they said let us reduce the weight of the patient, and after reducing the weight of the patient, we'll do bypass surgery. Till that time, we can keep either medical treatment or we can do optimal revascularization by stent. So I discussed with the family and we thought that we should do a stent in this case. This was looking very highly calcific lesion, as you saw. Mr. Basant will show you you can see proximal circumflex is a tight lesion. It has two angle. Then there is a distal circumflex or the OM, which is the tight lesion, and show the LAD. And the LAD has a post-stenting tight lesion and it all look calcified. So I was myself very skeptical whether stent will be able to do or not. We thought and we discussed with the family. Finally, we did a good bridge dilatation of the stent. The lesion which was just beyond the stent, I think it was part of instent restenosis or edge restenosis or whatever. And we were successful in doing a pre-dilatation. And then, of course, a stent from Pronova XR, which is also approved in our hospital. And this is 2.75 mm into 18 mm stent. And we did not need post-dilatation. We went up to 20 atmospheres and the final result was satisfactory. And I thought, let us stop this. The putting a wire into the circumflex was a challenge. As you see, there were two angles and therefore we had to take a balloon support to put the wire. And finally, we had to take a whisper wire, and with the whisper wire, we were able to cross. It took about 10-15 minutes. And putting a balloon was a little difficult, but I thought the stent will go. So after post-dilatation, we took a 2.75 millimeter stent, and you can see it was a little challenge. It was not easy to put the stent off through this. The two angles. One angle is, of course, the circumflex origin. Another angle is in the branch, which is going up. So when we were sure that we are away from the ostium, we did a dilatation and we deployed at the 20 atmospheric pressure, and then the result was reasonably okay. We felt that we should do a post dilatation. Anybody can say, go back, continue and showing this. This may require a post dilatation, but the stent boost was not so bad, and since I had gone to 20 atmospheric pressure, that means the stent is fully deployed. At least when the stent is deployed, the chances of subacute thrombosis is very low, and therefore one should not keep going up to this. We tried to put another balloon, but as I told you, there are two angles and the balloon was not crossed through this stent. And this is about, at least this has a minimal lesion residual stenosis, about 10-20%. But I'm satisfied because I had gone up to 20 atmospheric pressure. So coming back to this point, I used to show the stent boost of this. Stent boost is reasonably satisfactory. If it was simple, we could have done a post dilatation. Come back to me. So the message in this patient is a follow-up case of angioplasty stent, triple vessel disease, RCA is collateralized from the left system, LAD is having a tight lesion, which is also calcified lesion. I was very skeptical whether I should do angioplasty or not, but with the technical support of Mr. Basant and other members, we thought we should try to attempt it. I explained everything to the family that we may not be successful completely. And therefore, the patient said, okay, we go ahead, because the surgeon had refused to do the surgery at this point of time. So we did a very quick stent of the LAD, but circumflex, considering the angle, one angle is 90 degree at the origin of circumflex, and then of course there is another angle. So the simple regular wire did not go. What was the first vial we used?
Renato
wire did not good. And finally, we had to use a whisper wire. You know, the whisper wire has got a sheath which is very simple, and therefore it went away. But not only whisper, we had to use a balloon support. We kept the balloon at the proximal circumflex, and with the balloon support, the wire went there. We did a pre-dilatation, and then of course stent employment, and finally that is okay. So Basant, you will agree that we have done optimal revascularization. Come back here. We have the optimal revascularization with deployment of two stents. Circumflex OM I have left as a medical treatment. Considering the angle, I am sure that this will not be easy. And let us hope for the best. And let us do the follow-up, and we'll try to open the right coronary artery at the second stage. So optimal revascularization is a good choice, especially when the surgical team is not happy to operate. Thank you very much for watching this video. I'm Dr. Vivek Gupta from Apollo Hospital Delhi, Mr. Basant and Madam Lavlina from Apollo Hospital, with Mr. Himanshu doing the recording. Thank you very much.